Given the supply and demand functions, we've now found the equilibrium point as well as the consumer surplus. We want to finish by determining the producer surplus, given the same demand and supply functions, and equilibrium point. The formula for producer surplus is given here, but before we calculate this, let's review this concept. The benefit a producer receives when supplying more units at a price that is higher than a price at which fewer units would be supplied is called producer surplus. Looking at this red supply function, if a producer was willing to supply a certain amount of items at a lower price, but they actually sold the items at a higher price, it makes sense there's going to be a benefit to the producer. And we can measure this benefit by determining the producer's surplus. So this is our point of equilibrium, where the x-coordinate represents the quantity sold, and the y-coordinate represents the price. The area of this rectangle here would represent the total revenue received from selling all of those items. And the area of this rectangle would be Q times P. But then if we were to subtract out the area under the supply function on the same interval, or this area here, this remaining area in blue would represent the producer surplus, which would be the extra revenue received for not having to sell these items at a lower price. And this revenue would contribute to profit. On a more personal level, to get a better understanding of what this means, let's say you're trying to sell an old computer and you decide you're not willing to sell it for less than $100. And then if someone comes along and offers you $150, the extra $50 that you receive could be considered producer surplus. Now let's go back and take a look at our example. So the producer surplus is going to be equal to Q times P, or 1600 times 80, minus the integral from 0 to Q, or from 0 to 1600. Our integrand is going to be the supply function. So I'll write this as 2x to the 1 half dx. So we'll have 1600 times 80 minus, this is going to be 2 times x to the 1 half plus 1, that's 3 halves. So I'll have x to the 3 halves divided by 3 halves, but we'll multiply by 2 thirds instead. We'll evaluate this at 1600 and 0. 1600 times 80 is 128,000 minus, this is going to be 4 thirds, and then we'll replace x with 1600, so we'll have 1600 to the 3 halves minus, this will be 0 to the 3 halves, so we'll have 128,000 minus 4 thirds times 1600 to the 3 halves is 64,000. So we'll have 128,000 minus, let's round this to the nearest penny, so it's going to be $85,333.33. So our producer surplus will be this difference, which will be $42,666.67. And again, this represents the extra revenue received for selling more items at a higher price and will contribute to their profit.